Zanny. Zanny, Zanny or Zane is a character type of commedia dell'arte best known as an astute servant and trickster. The Zanny comes from the countryside and is known to be a dispossessed immigrant worker. Through time, the Zanny grew to be a popular figure who was first seen in commedia as early as the 14th century. The English word Zanny derives from this persona. The name Zanny is a variant of the name Gianni and was common in the Lombard Venetian countryside, which provided most of the servants to the wealthy nobles and merchants of Venice. In Italian, it is specifically a name of someone whose identity is not of any importance. It is one of the oldest characters in Commedia dell'arte, but over the course of time became subdivided into a number of similar characters with more specific traits. These included Arlecchino, Pulcinella, Mezzatino, and Truffaldino, as well as Beltram and Brighella. Arlecchino, for example, was more representative of a jester than an ordinary servant and was frequently depicted as very acrobatic. Zanny was shortened to Zan when used to provide further identification of an individual. For example, Zanganessa was the stage name of Alberto Nassoli, who was one of the first actors specializing in Zanny roles to perform outside of Italy. Some characters in commedia that are associated as Zanny are Arlecchino, Brighella, Scapino Mescalino and Mezzatino, Scaramuccia, Pulcinella, Pedrolino, Giangergolo, Tartaglia, Trappolino, and Burattino. The earliest literary evidence portrays Zanny as a servant of Pantaloni. Of all of the commedia archetypes, Zanny's survival instinct is the strongest. Zanny is also always hungry, which leads to a vision of utopia where everything is comestible, reminiscent of the followers of gluttony in carnival processions. A Zanny also has an animistic view of the world in that he senses a spirit in everything, so it could be eaten. Zanny is ignorant, loudish, and has no self-awareness. The simple act of thinking does not seem to be natural to Zanny. He is a very faithful individual who prefers to live in the present day. Zanny never looks for a place to sleep, it just seems to happen to him often in situations where it shouldn't. Lastly, all of his reactions are completely emotional. He is also a waiter for Pantaloni. The evolution of the character Zanny was of two distinct types, one of the silly servant and the other of the cunning servant. These two components developed over the course of the history of the Commedia dell'arte, and players began to specialize in the two types who were called First Zanny and Second Zanny. Examples of the First Zanny are Mezzatino and Brighella, of the Second Zanny, Arlecchino and Pulcinella. A scenario must always have at least two Zanny. The First Zanny is known to be clever and witty. The First Zanny is known as Il Furbo. The First Zanny can trick and cheat anyone whom they come across. It is a must that they are cynically sharp. The First Zanny is also known to be the go-between. The job of the First Zanny is to advance the action and give it some movement, with a slightly cynical twist. In some traditions, First Zanny are said to be from Val Brambana in the Bergamo country, in others he is attributed to the upper city of Bergamo. The Second Zanny is known as Lo Stupido. The Second Zanny must be foolish, clumsy, and dull. The Second Zanny is also unable to tell his right hand from his left hand. He is a dull-witted peasant who can be simple and also ridiculous. Second Zanny, in particular with Arlecchino, does not so much advance plot as maintain a steady stream of comic relief throughout the scenario. Second Zanny are assumed to be from the lower city of Bergamo. Between the two of them, they make up one person of less than average intelligence. Before developing this dualistic persona of the two types of clever and silly servant, Zanny was a character in its own right. The performance of a commedia actor relies on the acting itself. A scenario should be playable in different ways and seem different each time the audience sees it. The actors who play Zanny must be clever and equally talented, because an actor's success relies primarily on his dialogue partner. If the partner does not reply to him at the right moment or interrupts him in the wrong place, the actor's discourse falters and the liveliness of his wit is extinguished. He must be acrobatic, able to walk on his hands and on stilts, dance, skip and somersault. In this respect, the Zanny is one of the most physically demanding of all the masks. The Zanny's costume usually consists of white baggy clothing. This was similar to the dress of peasants and farm workers of the time. A specific type of Zanny, Brighella, wore accents of green to indicate his tricky and devious nature. Arlecchino, however, was known for his irregular colorette patches that eventually became the essence of the entire outfit. The Zanny are also known to sport a peaked hat and a wooden sword. The Zanny at first wore a full-face carnival mask, but because of the need for dialogue between Pantaloni and the Zanny, the bottom of the mask was hinged and eventually cut away altogether. The longer the nose of the Zanny, the stupider he is said to be. The stance of Zanny has a lowered center of gravity either from the earth or from carrying heavy bags and chairs. Zanny's back is arched when he stands up and his knees are bent in apart with splayed feet. The support knee is bent and the other leg is extended with his toe pointed. He switches his feet a lot while speaking or listening within the same position, and without his head moving up and down. Zanny's elbows are usually bent and arms half lifted. In Comedia, Zanny has a variety of at least six different types of walks. These walks include the Little Zanny, the Big Zanny, Zanny Running, Zanny Jubilant, Vain Zanny, and Soldier Zanny. The Little Zanny walk is a development of a basic stance. The Zanny's feet are constantly changing, but on each shift, the Zanny takes a tiny step forward. The feet are to be pointed, shoulders down, and elbows forward. The Zanny's knees come high off of the ground and to the side. The Zanny's head is to peck like a chicken, but the Zanny have to be sure not to bob their head up and down. A two-time rhythm is used with even beats. The Big Zanny walk includes sticking the chest forward and the backside up. The feet need to be in fourth extended with the knees bent. The Zanny has to lower his center of gravity. This walk can be used by a Zanny when he pretends to cross the stage without being seen or when he wants to cheat himself out of a difficult situation. Zanny running includes swift movements with legs kicking out in front of him with his toes pointed. His arms move opposite to his legs. Zanny jubilant involves skipping on his toes with his center of gravity moving from side to side. This type of walk also involves the hands being placed on the belt. Vain Zanny steps are a smaller version of the Big Zanny walk with the hands placed on the belt as seen in the Zanny jubilant. When the Zanny's leg lifts, his chest is forward and his arms are in the position of a chicken. This type of walk is used when the Zanny has a new button or a feather on his cap. Soldier Zanny holds a stick in one hand and inclines it over his shoulder like he is holding a rifle. The Zanny marches with his shoulders moving up and down in a two-time rhythm but in three beats. Tramper tramp, tramper tramp, 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 tramp. The Zanny is loud and his voice is coarse due to making a living outdoors trying to be heard in a market or busy street. The following sample dialogue shows how the Zanny uses his speech in Comedia. A lotso is a joke or gag in mime or in words. The following lotsy examples are short comic routines by the character type Zanny. In Lotsy of the Cat, the Zanny mimics the actions of a cat, demonstrating how the cat hunts for wild birds or how the cat cleans himself by scratching his ears with his feet and cleaning his body with his mouth. Sexual, scatological Lotsy. In Lotsy of Burying the Urine, the Zanny is told that burying his urine and the urine produced by his wife will give him a son. Zanny gets a urinal that produces both, and before he spills it into the soil, he treats it as a special fluid. Stupidity slash inappropriate behavior. In Lotsy of Counting Money, the Zanny divides Pantalone's money between Pantalone and himself in the following way: 1 for Pantalone, 2 for me, 2 for Pantalone, 3 for me, etc. Another popular Lotsy was Zanny walking behind his master mounted on a mule and goading it to go faster by blowing air from a pair of bellows onto the animal's anus. A Zanny is known to take and briefly keep items that belong to someone else. Some items that the Zanny would keep would be bags, letters, valuables, or food. Zanny's relationship to the audience is that he is the most sympathetic character and treats the audience collectively, so he is able to address the audience directly. Zanny contributes to the plot by being the principal contributor to any confusion. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.